Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a special Stevens Awe Baseball Show here on this August 5th, and we are just covering the big news that's going to be coming out, that's already first come out, and then another piece of this Biogenesis investigation will be coming out and possibly concluding in about 22 minutes. First, Major League Baseball has suspended the 12 players. Among those 12 players, Nelson Cruz, outfielder of the Rangers, and shortstops for the Tigers, Johnny Peralta, and for the Padres, Everett Cabrera. Among those three are among the 12 that are going to be suspended for 50 games. They agreed to do so to their connection with the Biogenesis investigation. I'll let you know about what's going on with Alex Rodriguez. His suspension is supposed to be official along with the other 12 in about 22 minutes. I'll cover this and all about this Biogenesis thing in our always daily San Diego's lookout, and this part of the show for Stevens Awe Baseball Show here on this August 5th here on Spreaker.com. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. As we're beginning Stevens Awe Baseball Show, I put a pretty long statement on the chat box. Questions and comments during the show will be accepted and respected. I also talk about them during the show. I bring them up. I highly suggest that you talk about Biogenesis. You can talk about anything you want baseball. But since I'm talking about this Biogenesis investigation, it is about to conclude very shortly from Major League Baseball's hands. Rather just stay on that topic because it's the big news all around sports in the nation. And this Biogenesis thing goes straight after Alex Rodriguez. Reports say that Alex Rodriguez will be suspended for through the 2014 season at 12 o'clock West Coast time, 3 o'clock East Coast time, which is about 20 minutes from now. I'll probably be out of here in about 15 minutes, so you guys can go on to ESPN. com. You guys can go to SportsCenter, listen in and at 3 o'clock Eastern Time, 12 o'clock West Coast Time. It is going to be officially announced that A-Rod is announced is going to be suspended through the 2014 year, and then the other suspensions from the 12 players that I have from the following will be have agreed to 50 game suspensions with their connection to the Biogenesis investigation. And here are these 12 players. Here are the 12 players. Nelson Cruz, the Rangers outfielder. Everett Cabrera, shortstop for the Padres. Johnny Peralta, shortstop for the Tigers. Antonio Bastardo, reliever for the Phillies. Francisco Cervelli, catcher for the Yankees, who is on the DL and who hasn't played a single game for the Yankees since April 26th since he broke his hand. Jordy Valspin, outfielder for the Mets, he's in the minor league system. Jesus Montero, catcher for the Mariners, who was acquired by the Yankees a couple years ago. He's also in the minors. Cesar Puello, Mets outfielder, in the minors. Sergio Escalona, Astros pitcher, he's also in the minors. And lastly from the minors, Fernando Martinez, an outfielder for the Yankees. He is in the minors as well. Fantino de los Santos and Jordan Norberto, they're both pitchers and they are both free agents. So once they are signed, which they're probably not going to be for a very long time, they'll have to serve their 50-game suspension from there. Very disappointing. But I know one team that was expecting the suspension of Johnny Peralta, and that was the Detroit Tigers. And that they acquired Jose Iglesias from the Red Sox in the three-team deal that sent former White Sox Jake Peavy over to the Red Sox. Jake Peavy actually won his Red Sox debut on Saturday night. But I think the Tigers were ready for a suspension, and they're ready to put in Iglesias, who before this suspension has been filling in for Miguel Cabrera, has been injured on and off to start the second half of the year. So the Tigers may be in a bit of a worry. They're losing John Peralta. Miggy's coming out in and out of the lineup with his injury. And at the same time, the Cleveland Indians, who have been red hot since the end of the All-Star break, they are only three games back in the American League Central of the Tigers, so any possibility of a takeover in the lead of the American League Central is a possibility. This is an underrated division, even though there's only two legit teams that have the possibility of making it to the playoffs in the Tigers and in the Indians. There is a possibility that the Royals could do something. The Royals had that big nine-game winning streak that got themselves up to above 500. They're 7.5 back. I say that's a lot of games. But if a lot of people are still considering the Baltimore Orioles as a possible team to make to the playoffs, then why aren't the Kansas City Royals in it? Kansas City Royals are 56-52. The Orioles are 61-51. There is a bit of a difference, but you know, if both those teams are in third place in a very tough division, then you know, why don't they get the possibility or even some recognition of being, recognized as a possible, playoff team. And I actually have to say this. I'll break down this more on the standings outlook, the standings lookout. The Detroit Tigers, Cleveland Indians, and Kansas City Royals. In their of all three of those teams in the last 10 games, they are 9-1. And for the Red Sox, they have lost 10 in a row. I'm not saying that. That probably is a good reason why Detroit, Cleveland, Kansas City are red hot, because they're all playing the White Sox at the same time. Think about that. But these suspensions are very, very big as of right now. Even though half of them, or maybe less than half of them, are minor leaguers, and I know probably six. I know half the players on this list. I know Nelson Cruz. I know Elvis Cabrera. I know Johnny Peralta. I know Antonio Bastardo. I know Francisco Cervelli. I know Jesus Montero. I know Faustino de los Santos. So that makes it seven, so a little more than half. These are notable guys, especially the three guys that are on the top of the list with the suspensions. These suspensions confirmed by FoxSports.com. Nelson Cruz, Everett Cabrera, Johnny Peralta. The problem with that, let's break down these players' stats first. Let's go to Everett Cabrera. And he was named to his first All-Star game in his career. He's a career 252 batter, and this year he's batting 283. And he was batting around 300. He's batting 346 in the last 7 days. Speaking about that, in August, he's batting 429. He's only had 14 at-bats, though, so I can't really say anything about that. But his stats over the years, he's had similarly short careers, 26. He started in 2009. He batted 255. 2010, he didn't have as many as bat. He only had 212 at bats. 2010, he batted 208. 2011, he only had 8 at bats. 2012, he batted 246. And then this year, he's batting 283. But he was on pace to have the most at bats in his career. He's batting 283. So you would think that a 40 point increase in his batting average would say something, and it did say something. His linkage to the Biogenesis investigation said a lot. And he's a short dude. He's 5'10", 190 pounds. Short dude. Very short dude. Next, let's go to Nelson Cruz, the well-known outfielder for the Texas Rangers. He's 33. He's had 8 years of experience in the major league level, 6'2", 230 pounds. From the Dominican Republic. Let's see the stats over the years. He had a breakout year in, well, not really a real breakout year, but he hit pretty good in 2008, even though he had 115 at bats. He batted 330, had 7 home runs, 26 RBIs. He's more of a backup type of guy. But he got the real role in 2009, the starting role. Started getting a lot of at bats, 462 at bats in 2009. He was batting 260 though. 2010, he had a really good year, 318 batting average, 22 home runs, 78 RBIs. And then after that, he hasn't hit above 270. Disappointment. 2011, 263. 2012, 260. And right now, he's batting 269. But he's still providing the power numbers from the souvenir city balls. 29 in 2000 and 29 in 2011, 24 in 2012, and right now 27 in 2013. So he was on pace to have 34 home runs on the year, but and he's only been a 30-plus home run hitter once back in 2009, when it seemed that it was the only time that he wasn't juiced and seemed like he was doing great. He hasn't had more than 90 RBIs in a single season. He had 90 in 2012, but he hasn't passed 90 yet. So these numbers, they look pretty consistent, and that's the reason why it's kind of a surprise for me that Nelson Cruz will be agreeing to suspension because of his involvement in the Biogenesis investigation. So this whole show, guys, is going to be on the Biogenesis investigation. You guys can qu questions and comments will be accepted and respected in the chat box, and you guys can talk about anything. But if you guys want to talk about what I'm talking about right now, we are talking about the Biogenesis situation on hand and what is going on here in Major League Baseball. Like I said, in 10 minutes, actually, it was 10 minutes, Alex Rodriguez will be officially suspended through the 2014 season. And also Major League Baseball will announce the suspensions of the other 12 players, among them Nelson Cruz, Everett Cabrera, and Johan Peralta, of agreeing to their 50-game suspensions respectively, as today gets for us the day goes on. Unfortunately, it's been a very unfortunate day in Major League Baseball. Let's actually go to one more stat. Let's go over to Johan Peralta, who, I haven't seen Johan Peralta as a very impressive player in Major League Baseball, but it's kind of weird that he's having pretty good stats. He's batting 305 on the year. His career batting average is 268. He's had 10 years of experience in Major League Baseball, so a very long time. He spent most of his career in Cleveland. He was traded to Detroit during the 2010 season. Split his 2010 year in Cleveland and Detroit, and then since then he's been playing Detroit. His batting average has gone up and down a lot. In his main years in Cleveland, he was batting 249, very poor batting average. But since he's gone to Detroit, his batting average has gone a little better. 2011, he batted 299, which is pretty good. But just last year, he batted 239, and he had more at bats, 13 home runs, 63 RBIs. But now he's batting 305, and that shows you something. That's kind of like an Everett Cabrera thing. Everett Cabrera, career batting average of 252. Now he's, pardon me, yeah, 252. Now he's batting around like 285. That says a lot if you're connected to Biogenesis, if you've actually taken it. Now Peralta is batting 239 last season. Now he's batting 305, and that's what 66 point jump from last year to this year. And his WAR has gone up, 2.6 has gone up 2.6 points in the WAR system. That's ridiculous. I don't know how that's even possible. And I actually have to point this out. Johan Peralta has never hit above 300 in a single season in his career. The closest he's been to is 299 in 2011 and 292 back in 2005 when he was at the Indians. He had a career best 24 home runs and 78 RBIs. But he strikes out a lot. 152 strikeouts in 2006, 146 strikeouts in 2007, 98 in 2013. So he averages 105 strikeouts a year, which is quite a lot, especially from a guy that's for a guy in a position that's supposed to be a contact hitter at the shortstop position. You see Derek Jeter, he doesn't strike out a lot. And I can actually give you his stats very short, but it's a surprise to me that this is the case, that batting 239 last year, batting 305 right now. That's ridiculous. How is that even possible? It's kind of like a jump over Planet Nine or whatever. Jeter, he's averaged 91 strikeouts a year, which is quite a lot, which is like a little above the average in a way, but you know, that's definitely lower than 105. But Jeter, I can't compare Jeter and Peralta together, but I'm just saying, if you want to be an elite shortstop, you can't strike out a lot. And that's the problem with some guys, and that's the problem with some other guys. But it's if you're a 268 career batter and batting 305 right now, there's definitely juicing going on. But like I said, Derek Jeter's teammate, actually, Alex Rodriguez, will be suspended through the 2014 season. You guys can turn on to SportsCenter, ESPN, Major League, MLB Network, anything to just listen in, because this is going to be official along with the other 12 suspensions in about 5 minutes. Also, guys, questions and comments during the show will be accepted and respected. I'll talk about them during the show and, you know, and all that stuff about Biogenesis. Joe Girardi, manager for the Yankees, does have Alex Reese penciled in the lineup against the White Sox, starting their three-game series tonight. You know, Alex Reese will be suspended, but it seems like A-Rod will definitely appeal. And if A-Rod does appeal, which he will be able to play on Monday, because baseball players are eligible to play when they are appealing a suspension. Yankees expect Rodriguez to be eligible to play Monday, according to Buster Only, because they expect his suspension to be tied solely to a drug policy violation and thus eligible to be appealed. There have been some thought that Commissioner Bud Selig would try to suspend Rodriguez under the best interest of baseball clause, which would have made the suspension effective immediately, and which is the case for the 12 players that have agreed to suspensions, like Nelson Cruz, Everett Cabrera, Antonio Bastardo. Rodriguez has maintained that he would appeal any suspension under the Major League Baseball drug policy, which would make him eligible to play until such an appeal is heard. Rodriguez's suspension will likely run through the end of the 2014 season. About 12 players will also be suspended. Barring an agreement, Rodriguez's appeal would be heard by arbitrator Frederick Horowitz. Asked about his use of the word penciled, Girardi said this, quote, "That's just a term. None of us use pencils or pens. We type," end quote. Then he added, quote, "I'm not going to bring him up to sit him," end quote. Rodriguez could help the Yankees' struggling offense, which could be without Jeter, who is dealing with a strained right calf. Girardi said he had talked to Rodriguez after his final rehab game for Double-A Trenton, and that Rodriguez had laughed about his four walks in the game. Turned out, however, that the two had merely exchanged text messages, through which the manager said he was able to deduce that A-Rod was in a good mood. But A-Rod will be probably playing tonight, because he will be appealing the suspension given to him in about a few minutes. I'm actually going to turn on the TV right now to look at this. We'll actually be going to music break right now. When I come back, more on the Biogenesis investigation and the suspensions that are coming down to 13 players, including the most notable, the three-time MVP, Alex Rodriguez. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Seaman's All Baseball Show here on a beautiful August 5th day in America. We are just seconds away from finding out the official announcement of Alex Rodriguez's suspension and also the official announcement of the suspensions from or onto the other 12 players, among them Nelson Cruz, Everett Cabrera, Johnny Peralta, and Antonio Bastardo. All four of them have been previous All-Stars. And this is from TJ Quinn. The Players Union made a lay appeal to Major League Baseball for a deal for A-Rod's suspension, but there will be no more negotiations. Let's give out the break. So we are just seconds away from finding out what's going on. But since A-Rod is appealing this suspension, since that is the case, is A-Rod will be playing today. Will be playing today in this the beginning of a 3-game series against the White Sox. The Yankees leaving their hotel for U.S. Cellular Field to face the Sox. 8 o'clock Eastern time, 5 o'clock West Coast time, and we're just waiting now for the announcement of A-Rod's suspension, official announcement. This is what Evan Longoria is saying. Tweet: today's a sad day for Major League Baseball, the fans of this great game, all the players who have been negatively affected by others' selfishness. And that's a tweet from Rays third baseman Evan Longoria. Evan Longoria tweeting that on Twitter. This is really big news right now. A-Rod will be playing tonight, but he is under he will be appealing. He's playing because he's appealing his suspension. But anyways, let's. Jesus Montero. A lot of you probably heard of him from the Yankees. Minor league system is one of the top prospects. He's been struggling as the Mariners catcher. He's down in the minor leagues. He is one of the suspended players in this whole thing. Again, guys, questions and comments during the show will be accepted and respected. I'll talk about your comments and answer your questions on the show. And this is about the Biogenesis situation, the investigation that's really unfolding and hopefully concluding today. And like Evan Longoria said, a sad day in baseball where suspensions to 12 players and possibly and probably 13 players, if you include A-Rod into that picture, will be the case. And this is a report by TJ Quinn of ESPN Major League Baseball to suspend A-Rod through the 2014 season for violating the league's PED policy. A-Rod will be appealing that because A-Rod has a legitimate defense in saying that he hasn't even failed a drug test yet, even though he's admitted to taking PEDs before in his days with the Rangers and his early days with the Yankees. He has not failed a drug test, so that's his defense, and he feels like the PED policy violation is, you know, shouldn't be in this suspension of supposedly 214 games. That is including the games this year. That is including the games, the regular season for next year. So you have about 52 games left in the entire season for the Yankees for the regular season. They're probably not going to make it to the playoffs. They're in fourth place right now in the American League East. They're struggling. They're 4-6 in the last 10. And plus the fact that you have another 161 games that you're going to be missing for next year, and the possible amount of games that you're missing if the Yankees make it to the playoffs next year, if they even bring back their star players from injury like Mark Teixeira, like Curtis Granderson, who is hopefully coming back shortly, and all those guys, Derek Jeter possibly being healthy for his 19th year. And A-Rod's not going to be there, and there's going to be a lack in third base once again, not just this year, not just for the rest of this year, possibly until he gets suspended officially and the appeal is over with. And then for next year, what are they going to get? Kevin Youkilis is also injured. He had to switch over to the first base. He's getting a little bit old. He's not as fast and as limber as he was in his younger days. So Major League Baseball is official, is suspending Alex Rodriguez through the 2014 year for his violation of PED. The league's PED policy is official right now that it is a suspension for A-Rod. It is official. It is official, ladies and gentlemen. A-Rod is suspended. But Joe Girardi does have him penciled in because A-Rod is appealing it. And, you know, I've heard a lot of this on SportsCenter, on Major League MLB Network. A-Rod is getting a lot of support by his teammates that he's going to be playing tonight. And, you know, the possibility of him getting a lot of, you know, a negative response from the fans and really hurting the game of baseball, like Evan Longoria said in his tweet. It's a shame that this is the case, and you know, it's like Evan Longoria said, I have to go right back to it. It's really a powerful quote right there from him, from his tweet, pardon me. It is a sad day in baseball. I want to actually bring up something from the other 12 suspensions. I want to bring up Nelson Cruz and Johan Peralta. Those two guys, okay, they're the leading, they're one of the key hitters on their teams, but their teams are in the middle of, you know, the playoff race. I talked to you guys earlier about the Tigers, the possibility of them losing their AL Central lead is a possibility. The Indians are only 3 games back. And if the Royals have another surge that they had last week with a 9-game winning streak, the possibility of the Royals taking over the Tigers is still likely. And I'm not saying it's going to be 100%. I can say it's about, you know, 40% or even 30%. It's still a possibility. But let's go to the Rangers now. I totally forgot about the Rangers. My station here in the Stevens All Baseball Studios are located in the Bay Area. I'm not going to say any sort of city, but the Oakland A's are atop the AL West, and they're in first place. They're 2.5 ahead of the Texas Rangers. And since Nelson Cruz, who's leading the Rangers in home runs and RBIs, is going to be gone for the rest of the year, there goes a vital piece in your offense. Also, you lost Josh Hamilton during the offseason as he went to Los Angeles. Think it's just a big – the Rangers have lost many players. They've lost many players lately. They lost C.J. Wilson a couple of years ago to the Angels. They lost Josh Hamilton to the Angels. They actually got some other additions. They got Ryan Dempster last year. He didn't really improve. He didn't really help the team. And he's now with the Red Sox now. You have Matt Garza now, who they got another pitcher from the trade deadline. Just like last year, Ryan Dempster. This year, it's Matt Garza, and he's doing okay. He lost in his last start to the A's. That was a pivotal series for the Rangers to do some work into catching up on the A's in that series, in that division race. I actually want to correct myself. When I said that A-Rod will be missing 214 games, it is not the case. It's a little correction. It's 211 games. That's still a lot of games. That's about one full season, which it is an entire 2014 season, and about 50 games. So about, you know, a little less than a third of the year, or maybe a little bit more than a third of a year. But A-Rod missing about more than a year of baseball, and possibly in the next few games that A-Rod will be playing under his appeal, this might be the last at-bats he could be taking in his career. You know, missing an entire year at the age of 38, that really takes a toll on you as, you know, the years go on, and that's a real shame of things in this, you know, entire process of the investigation and all that stuff. Yeah, he's 38, and then once he's gonna come back in 2015. He's gonna be turning 40 that year, and who's gonna say, you know, what's gonna be going on? You know, what's gonna be the is he gonna be ready to play? Is he gonna be, you know, even ready to perform and do his best. This is his career numbers for Alex Rodriguez. 300 batting average, 647 home runs, 1,950 RBIs with an OBP on-base percentage of 384. Before his salary is at $29 million, he's going to lose about $36 million in his salary. That's counting this year and next year. But before he A-Rod was, admitted that he took PEDs. He is kind of like the idol. The guy that, has been cleaned through the steroid era that has been marked by Asterix by the home run hitters like Mark McGwire, Sammy Sosa, Barry Bonds, Jose Canseco. Those guys. Everybody thought he was clean. And I can say that's the case for Gentile, but Gentile didn't take PEDs. He was clean throughout his entire career, and he's definitely going to be a Hall of Famer. Gentile is a definite Hall of Famer in a few years, and I respect that entirely. And he deserves to be, a Hall of Famer because, he's that one guy that is the idol of some people who believe that, you need to respect the clean players. And that they don't care if they're being cheated. They're playing their brand of baseball, and that's it. But A-Rod, he seemed like the clean guy that could have even gone after the home run mark. He was at 647. He's around 68 home runs away from passing Henry Aaron. He needs another 115 to tie Barry Bonds, and that does not look like that's going to be the case if he comes back to the 2015 year, and he's going to be turning 40 that July in 2015. So it's a real shame that everybody thought this guy is the great player that he could be. But I actually like to point out something. Tigers and Indians, tight race to the American League Central. They're actually starting a 3-game series tonight in Cleveland. It's going to be a big series over there. No Johnny Peralta. Jose Iglesias will be in there. I'm thinking that Don Kelly, backup bench player for the Tigers, will be in the spot for Miguel Cabrera. Hopefully Miguel Cabrera can even play today. I'm not 100% sure if he will play today because he was out of the lineup yesterday. Even though that's the case, the Tigers have still been winning, mainly because their batting average is number one in the league. Their on-base percentage is number one in the league. Their slugging is third in the league, and that's pretty impressive. But like I said, Jose Iglesias will be replacing Johnny Peralta since he is getting suspended. And I think Iglesias might be the replacement for Peralta. Peralta being, along with Nelson Cruz, being a free agent after this year, definitely says that, maybe Jose Iglesias is going to be the next brand of infielder in Detroit. And that could be the case, and that's probably going to be the case because Jose Iglesias, at a very young age, could provide a lot for a team that has been hitting a lot over the years, especially with the resurgence of Miguel Cabrera, Prince Fielder, the addition of Prince Fielder, Austin Jackson, who's up and down, but when he is up, he's really hot and he can hit the ball extremely well. But Austin Jackson this year batting .262. I'm thinking who's going to be at shortstop, who's going to be at third base if Miguel Cabrera is injured. And, that could mean a lot in a very short period of time. Iglesias batting .323 this year. He's a hitter. He has the bat from the third base, or probably going to be the shortstop position, to be a productive batter and to be possibly the next Omar Vizquel. If I know he's not the best, he's not a def. I can't. I'm not going to compare Jose Iglesias' defense to Omar Vizquel, but he could be the type of guy that has good defense and at the same time can hit the ball pretty well. But anyways, I'm going to wrap up very shortly. When we come back to our last music break, I'll be giving you guys the standings look at. You're listening to Stephen's All Out Baseball Show here on a beautiful August 5th in the Bay Area in California, here on the National Sports Radio Station in affiliation with Spreaker.com. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Stephen's All Baseball Show. Major League Baseball has suspended A-Rod through the 2014 year, but I have this to say: breaking news. The suspension begins Thursday. It is not. It will not start. As of right now, it'll begin Thursday, but A-Rod will be under appeal. So since it begins Thursday, A-Rod will be. It will be able to play in a three-game series versus the White Sox, and that's probably the three games he's going to be playing until the 2015 year, probably. Robbie's, like I said, expected to appeal and is scheduled to make his season debut tonight against the Sox. Let's go to the standings lookout presented by Spreaker. .com. The American League. Let's start with the Eastern Division. Let's start with the East Division. The Sox, the Boston Red Sox, 68-45. They're just above the 602 winning percentage. 39-21 at home. Very good. But they only have a one-game lead over the Tampa Bay Rays, who have been red hot of late. The Rays are 66-45. After that, the O's, the Baltimore Orioles, 61-51, 6.5 back of the Red Sox. The Yankees, like I said, who have been struggling in the plate for the entire year, 57-53, just 4 games above 500, 9.5 behind the Red Sox, 8.5 behind the Rays. And then lastly, the Toronto Blue Jays, the only team below 500 in the American League East. They are in last, 51-60, 16 games back of the Red Sox. Let's go to the American League Central. Detroit and Cleveland playing in a three-game series in Cleveland starting today. Detroit 64-45, Cleveland 62-49. Those teams are only 3 games apart. So if the Indians sweep, we will see a tie in the AL Central on Wednesday, and that would be big for the Indians possibly getting back to the playoffs for the first time in a few years. After that, the Kansas City Royals, who still have a possibility of making the playoffs, they are 4 games above 500, 7.5 back of Detroit, only 4.5 behind Cleveland, so they still have a possibility of taking over Cleveland for second place if Cleveland starts to fall off the map. After that goes Minnesota and the Chicago White Sox, the two teams below 500 in the AL Central. The Minnesota Twins are 15.5 behind the Detroit Tigers. The White Sox are 24 games behind the Detroit Tigers, and they have lost 10 in a row. Mark that, you know, doesn't really sound all too impressive. The Tigers, though, have won 8 in a row. Let's go to the AL West. The A's still have a lead in the American League West. They have a 2.5 game lead over the Texas Rangers. The A's are 64-47. The Rangers 62-50. After that, it goes the Seattle Mariners, who have a half game lead in third place ahead of the Los Angeles Angels. That's awesome. 52-59 for the Mariners, 51-59 for the Angels. And after that, the Houston Astros, who have lost 4 straight, they're 36-74, 27.5 back of the A's. They have a 327 winning percentage. That is the worst in Major League Baseball. In second place now, it's the Chicago White Sox. In the National League now, in the East, the Atlanta Braves still remain the lone above 500 team in the National League East. They are 67-45, 38-15 at home, and they have won at 10 straight. They are red hot, especially the Upton brothers, who have been starting to hit the ball better, like at the beginning of the year when Justin Upton was batting out of control. Washington, 54-57, 12.5 back of Atlanta. It seems like if the season ended now, Atlanta will definitely be the lone team out of the National League East making of the playoffs. After Washington, it goes Philadelphia, 16.5 back, 50-61. The New York Mets, 16.5 back as well, but they are 49-60. Then after that, the worst team in the National League, the Miami Marlins, 43-67, a 391 winning percentage, 23 back of the Braves. In the National League Central, the Pittsburgh Pirates have taken the lead after them and the St. Louis Cardinals were flip-flopping since the All-Star break ended. Pittsburgh 67-44, St. Louis 65-45. Those teams are separated by a game and a half. Cincinnati 61-51, 6.5 back of the Pittsburgh Pirates, 5 games back of the St. Louis Cardinals. And after that, it goes really bad. The Chicago Cubs 18 games behind the Pittsburgh Pirates. They are 13 games below 500 as they are 49-62. And after that, the Milwaukee Brewers, the Brew Crew, 47-64, 20 games back of the Pirates. Lastly, the National League West, the LA Dodgers have a 5.5 game lead over the D-backs as they are 61-49. Dodgers are 8-2 in the last 10. They have won 4 straight. After Arizona, it goes San Diego are 10 back, who have just lost shortstop Evan Cabrera due to suspension in connection with the biogenesis investigation. San Diego 52-60. They are 7-3 in the last 10. And then after San Diego in fourth, you got Colorado 10.5 back, 52-61. They're trying to, you know, get on a hot streak with the return of Tulowitzki and Cargo, and if they can provide the offense. They are 3-7 in the last 10. Also 3-7 in the last 10. And last place in the National League West is the San Francisco Giants, 49-61, 12 games back of the Dodgers. Giants, even though they are 28-27 at home, they are 21-34 on the road this year. And that is all from the Spreaker.com studios for the affiliation with the National Sports Radio Station. That is it here from the Stevens All Up Baseball Show studios here in the Bay Area, along with Robert Deers, president of National Sports, along with the other members such as Sam Rosen, Cameron Sardeghi, Nick Rice, Andrew Goldstein, James Thomas McDaniels, Jason Gerline, and the others in our group. I'd like to thank you for listening, and also keep listening to our shows here on the National Sports Radio Station, as they will be flying out of this station in the next week because Right now, the play-by-play camp in Los Angeles at UCLA is taking place right now, and that you guys need to listen to all the commentating and the analysis that our members are going to be giving out for the next week. These shows will be covered during the night. So for the East Coast people, it'll be around 7. It'll be around 10 o'clock to 12 o'clock East Coast time. And for the West Coast, you're a little bit lucky. It'll be around 7 o'clock to 9 o'clock. Those shows will start. And you guys can pretty much listen and listen and hear the announcements and the updates made by our members as the shows go on during the week. Thank you very much, everybody. Like our page on Facebook. Like my page on Facebook as well. National Sports, National Sports Radio Station on Facebook, and Stevens All Out Baseball Show on Facebook as well. And then follow us here on Spreaker.com as well as Twitter.com. That is National Sports Radio Station. Thank you very much, everybody, for listening to our show. Thank you for having me be a part of your day. And unfortunately, for the baseball fans listening here on our show, it is a sad day in baseball with the suspensions coming down to Oscar Rodriguez and 12 other players. That is it here. Have a great day, folks, and go National Sports.